Hello, interdisciplinary cooperative education students. Today is Thursday, August 27th. And I believe on the last video I misspoke and I said that we are going to talk about the Medicaid waiver, but that's actually tomorrow on Friday. And we're going to talk about Erskine Green. So Erskine Green is housed within the Courtyard by Marriott in Muncie, Indiana. The program, it provides a unique personalized training experience for each student. This is a 10 to 13 week training session, depending on what topic or job you are interested in learning about. And during this program, you live in the hotel and you also participate in classroom instruction along with hands-on instruction. We are going to watch an overview, a tour of the program, and then a couple of the job training programs that they have there. So here's the tour of looking inside of the Erskine Green Training Institute. Now we'll take a look at the hotel desk agent. This is one of the programs they have.
Welcome to the Erskine Green Training Institute, where opportunities for employment begin for people with disabilities. The Institute provides a unique post-secondary vocational for a variety of jobs in the hotel, food service, and healthcare environments. Here's more about just one of the careers for which you can receive training.
My name's Kelly and I'm a front desk agent. The command center is kind of how we think of ourselves. Everything kind of goes through us, from housekeeping to groups that we have coming in to checking a guest in, checking a guest out. If the bistro needs help, we help them. We kind of do a little bit of everything.
For the front desk agent, you look for someone who is personable and outgoing. They are the first point of contact in the hotel for the guest and usually the last as well. So they are the person that is there to create that rapport and relationship with them so that while they're here, if there's anything that they need, that they have a point of contact.
We deal with money on a daily basis. When you come to work in the morning, you usually will have a drawer that has cash in it, and you have to, when you check a guest out, you know, you may have to run their credit card, or if they choose to pay with cash, you have to know how to count that properly. There's a lot of computer work involved with this job. From the very beginning, when we come on our shift, we log into the computer. We have to know our system. With an unhappy guest as the front desk person, they call us first. When they have a problem, it's up to us to make sure that their issue is resolved as best as we can.
They have to be able to stay composed and poised and be able to handle those, as well as do what they need to do to take care of the guests, but keep that relationship and keep the poise and that level of service.
Although we might be the first and last people that guests see, we have housekeeping manager, maintenance, and engineer staff as well. We work really closely with each department. To help guests find where to go for dinner or to go shopping or any of kind of local area, it's very important to be familiar with the area. And I struggled with that when I first started working here. I'm not from here. I learned what restaurants we recommend, what places we recommend to go to. Working in the hotel business is fun. I've had a lot of jobs. This is probably my favorite. You know, I meet different people every day, and most of the time people are happy because they're on vacation, or, you know, they're not at home, or they're getting a break from this or that. I like this job because I'm never bored and I never stand still. I'm always moving.
So now we will watch another video of an example of a job. They have the three areas of job categories that they train you in. You have to pick one of the jobs within either food service and restaurant, health care support, or hospitality. So there's only three different areas that you can pick from the one training program. You just do one specific job for the training. And the next one is kitchen cook.
Welcome to the Erskine Training Institute, where opportunities for employment begin for people with disabilities. The Institute provides a unique post-secondary vocational training for a variety of jobs in the hotel, food service, and healthcare environments. Here's more about just one of the careers for which you can receive training.
My name's Tabby and I'm a prep cook. All of our recipes are in a recipe book, and the recipes tell you where to find our food, what to do with the food, how to prepare it, and how to cool it after it's cooked.
In a prep cook, we look for someone that's able to complete a list while multitasking, have a uniform in their job, everything looks good and professional, so it looks well on the product as a finish for people to eat.
So I take meat out of the cooler and put it onto a stove or put it in the oven to cook it to a certain temperature. I take dough and make bread, let it proof and then cook it, and take dough and make different breadstick recipes. I cut up vegetables and I prepare soups. We make our soups from scratch, and so you follow a recipe to prepare a soup, and it has step-by-step instructions to make the soup. After my prep list is finished, I clean the prep kitchen. So I clean different appliances in the prep kitchen, and then I sweep them off the floors and make sure everything looks like it did the morning when I came in. It's very important to be conscious of cleanliness in the prep kitchen. We always wear gloves. We keep sanitizer water buckets in the back and keep hot sanitizer water in the buckets to clean the surfaces after we're finished prepping each item.
Attention to detail is highly important for a prep cook. If they miss a certain step, it could kind of mess up the entire process of that food product.
Prep cook doesn't experience the pressure that a line cook experiences. Prep cooks come in early in the morning to start prepping before the restaurant opens, and then are usually done before the restaurant gets too busy. Best part about my job is the people that I work with. I also enjoy knowing that all of the food that I prepare goes out to serve customers, so I take pride in the food that I prepare. One day I ordered a pizza and I realized that I had prepared everything on the pizza. So I had made the dough, and I had made the pizza sauce, and I had made the chicken that was on the pizza, and I had cut up the tomatoes that was on the pizza. and it made me feel really good. My job is fun. I enjoy my job. I enjoy the different people that I work with. There's always somebody to talk to in the kitchen and kind of hang out with.
So that one is a prep cook, the example of a prep cook.
Hey everybody,
another one is a patient transporter within the healthcare area realm.
So at AGTI, there are
nine different training
programs that we train, and oftentimes... Well,
Erskine Green Training Institute, where opportunities for employment begin for people with disabilities. The Institute provides a unique post-secondary vocational training for a variety of jobs in the hotel, food service, and healthcare environments. Here's more about just one of the careers for which you can receive training.
My name is Stormy, and I'm a patient transporter. A transporter will take patients to and from testing sites, as well as discharging them and taking them anywhere throughout the hospital. There are a variety of places that we will take the patients throughout the hospital. We may take them to get an x-ray, CAT scan, pulmonary, stress test. We transport patients by cart, wheelchair, and also by bed. The patient is able to walk, we'll walk them from their room out to the cart, which we'll park in the hall, or we may pull them over if they're unable to walk for whatever reason. We have a team of four people who, including the nurse, myself, and then two other techs or whatever it may be, will pull the patient over.
With the patient transporter job, we are looking for employees that can do a physical job by moving patients. They're required to be on their feet for their whole eight-hour shift, moving, pulling over patients, putting them in wheelchairs, pushing them down the hallways to all their test sites. And it really takes somebody that can really endure being on their feet for an eight-hour shift.
You always will have people to help you transport the patient, and you have more if they're larger, but it's definitely a physically active
job. With this job, really want somebody that can really interact with patients. A lot of times you're dealing not with only the patients but their family members.
There's always patient interaction while transporting the patient. You know, lots of times we'll go to the room and ask them how you're doing today, how are you feeling, how long have you been here?
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, I'm here to take you down for an x-ray.
In the patient transporter role, we're transporting patients that really have sometimes a lot of anxiety because of either the test they're going down for or the procedure that they've got to go have done. So we need somebody that can talk to them, ease their mind, get their mind off of that procedure or test that they're getting ready to go down for.
There's a lot of satisfaction working in a hospital. It's probably one of the most rewarding jobs that I've had. You know, you have a greater appreciation for health and life.
And finally, we will have we will watch a graduation ceremony. Part of the program is not only the job training piece of it, but it's also getting acclimated to the community and being partnered. You also are partnered with a Ball State student, and you have recreation and leisure activities that you can do and participate in, and making choices and getting around the community on the bus. And you will see that in this graduation ceremony. You'll see them, they are working and learning how to do the jobs that they're being trained on, but they also are participating as a young adult in a college community with peers of their same age.
You got the whole world in your pocket, but you just don't know. Everybody's smiling at you everywhere you go. It's like you've got that secret that everybody else wants to know. You won't ever let it go.
So that was Erskine Green Training Institute in Muncie, Indiana. So there's the job that you will pick within the restaurant, the healthcare, or the hospitality industry. You will just pick one specific job that you're trained into. And they do offer tours. So again, step one, if you are interested in this, you definitely want to tour the program. They have general tours and it's open. You have to fill out a registration. Obviously now they're doing virtual tours, but you have to fill out that registration. But I will leave the website up, the link to the website up, so that you have that information to look up more information about it. In addition to the training that you do, there's going to be some social piece of it where you, you know, interact with the community, you go do fun things, you know, they have a pool at the hotel, you're staying at the hotel, you're living there. So there's some things that you have to be independent at. You have to be able to get up by yourself, and you have to be able to, you know, take a shower by yourself, get dressed by yourself, work on managing money and riding the bus system. They will train you how to ride the bus, but you have to, you know, do some of that while you're there. So it's a great program all around to learn how to be an independent adult on top of learning vocational skills. VR, it does cost, and it is an expensive program, but VR does help in some instances pay for that training. But it is an expensive program, and you do have to apply just like everything else. But step one, I definitely would say, is go and observe the program. So that is that. And tomorrow, I want you to, today, I want you to fill in the notes and the other questions I have for you on the quiz. And then tomorrow, I'm going to talk about the Medicaid waiver. All right, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.